Say what you will of Mortal Kombat. Criticize its cheesy acting. Criticize its awful special effects. Criticize it as yet another video game-based movie in a dreary ocean of video game-based movies. One must eventually admit, however, that aside from being inherently watchable and at the very least entertaining, Mortal Kombat is clearly the best game-based movie ever made. Firstly, it's faithful to its source material in ways other game movies just aren't. It doesn't take massive liberties with the story, instead giving MK fans what they expect: a martial arts tournament with fighting, shouting, and little else getting in the way. A few minor changes are made, but unlike Mario Brothers, which reinvented its entire universe, or Uwe Boll films, which use game licenses for advertising only and are basically original films, Kombat preserves the essence of the games and doesn't reimagine characters with only trace elements of their origins. Instead, we're given an authentic live-action version of them. Sonya's a special forces agent out to get Kano. Johnny Cage is an arrogant Hollywood star wanting legitimacy. Liu Kang is the hero, and not relegated to the background so the white heroes can be white all over the screen. And Raiden? Well, like I said, they did make some changes. This is carried on with the costumes. Again, other movies may have slight visual references for fans, or do what Street Fighter did and contrive a way of eventually getting them to wear their recognizable attire, but Mortal Kombat didn't care. It didn't care how silly a real-life yellow ninja would look, it just did it, and because it's Scorpion, we allow it. And I think we should give props to the fact the fight scenes are legitimately good. Proper martial arts action in some entertainingly varied sets, most of the features characters each get in a fantastic physical performance, and there are some highly memorable battles. Scorpion versus Cage is over the top in a fun way, while Kang versus Reptile is just bloody terrific viewing. Of course, this is a game movie, and as such needs some hammy acting to seal the deal. Kari Hiroyuki Tagawa is deliciously overzealous, the man able to contort his face into big cat style sneers as he scowls and spits his way through the story. Christopher Lambert may be utter garbage as Raiden because he's Christopher Lambert, but you can't deny, at the very least, his Asian god by way of slightly confused Frenchman performance is at the very least funny stuff to watch. But why is it that Mortal Kombat can get away with being so faithful and succeeding where more high-profile games have failed? Firstly, I think that lower profile has only helped. Mortal Kombat doesn't have a strong individual story to ruin like Silent Hill or Resident Evil. Mortal Kombat's story had nothing to trash because it was already kinda trash, and I actually mean that as a compliment. It's a delightful car wreck of B-movie subplots and excessive silliness. Ed Boon and the Mortal Kombat team have displayed a long-standing willingness to not give a damn what it does. Why is that lizard also a ninja? Why isn't that lizard also a ninja? Come on! What's the big forearm thing that looks kind of dumb? Who cares? It's there and it's going to fight you! One thing I actually respect about Mortal Kombat as a series is that it just does what feels good with its story, characters, and premise. Glitches become characters. No idea is too ridiculous. And all this worked for a video game movie that didn't take itself too seriously. It embraced the fact it was a video game movie, rather than displayed contempt for it, and ran with the ball. Like the games it was based on, it didn't run away from nonsensical ideas, it just did them because it felt good and was the right thing to do. The result? The best game movie ever made. Bar none, damn right.
I don't think so.